Hey there, I'm back again to chat about one sneaky cause of PCOS that you may not have ever heard about. Fetal programming. What the heck is that? Well, in simple terms, it means that exposure to certain hormones or chemicals while still in your mother's womb may set you up for PCOS later in life. Things like extra testosterone or chemicals that mess with your natural hormone balance can tweak how your hypothalamus, pituitary gland, and ovaries regulate each other. And that can spiral into the cluster of symptoms we know as PCOS. Irregular menstrual cycles, excess hair growth, ovarian cysts, and all that jazz. So even though you can't remember it, your fetal development may be one piece to the PCOS puzzle. So now let's unpack how it all happens and what it means for you. You ever wonder why some women seem prone to PCOS from an early age? Well, the answer lies in fetal development. Exposure to excess androgens, which are male sex hormones in the womb during critical periods of development, can program a fetus for PCOS later in life. Some women experience elevated androgen levels during pregnancy, which expose their fetus to higher amounts of these hormones. This early androgen exposure causes abnormalities in the hypothalamic pituitary ovarian axis, also known as the HPO axis, the system that controls reproduction. So these changes set the stage for increased androgen production, irregular periods, and cyst formation on the ovaries, all hallmarks of PCOS. So not only are androgen levels impacted, but fetal programming may also influence the development of insulin resistance, a common feature of PCOS. Exposure to excess sugars, obesity, or gestational diabetes during pregnancy can stimulate the fetus to produce higher amounts of insulin. Over time, cells become less responsive to insulin's effects. This insulin resistance often persists into adulthood and contributes significantly to PCOS symptoms. The effects of fetal programming on PCOS risk are significant, but not inevitable, with close monitoring, healthy lifestyle changes, and medical intervention when needed, the impact of fetal programming can be reduced. The key is awareness and action. Just understanding how events during pregnancy may have shaped your PCOS risk, and then take steps to support your metabolic and reproductive health. So here's what you need to know. Exposure to high levels of male sex hormones, also known as androgens, before you were even born may have contributed to your PCOS. This is known as fetal programming, and research shows it plays a significant role. Look at it like this. While in the womb, your little body was busy developing based on the hormones and environment around you. If your mom had high testosterone during pregnancy, some of that likely passed through the placenta to you. This excess androgen exposure caused your ovaries and adrenal glands to form in a way that made them prone to overproduce testosterone later on, contributing to PCOS symptoms like irregular periods, acne, and excess body hair. Fetal programming may have also caused changes in your hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis, the system that controls your stress response. An altered HPA axis can increase androgen levels and make PCOS symptoms worse. The good news is some lifestyle changes may help rebalance the hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis, decreasing androgens and relieving symptoms. While none of us can change our fetal development, understanding its role in PCOS can help you develop better management strategies. Talk to your doctor about lifestyle changes and medical therapies that can correct hormone imbalances and give you the best chance of overcoming this complex condition. And so that's why it's good to know this information and understand what could have been a cause of your PCOS. Next, I want to talk about how to reduce exposure to endocrine disruptors during pregnancy. Pregnancy is a critical period, and exposing the fetus to endocrine disruptors can have lasting impacts. These chemicals are found in many plastics, cosmetics, like our makeup, personal care products, and household cleaning products. These chemicals interfere with the baby's hormone system development. So I want to give you some tips on how we can reduce exposure to endocrine disruptors during pregnancy. So tip number one, you want to watch out for BPA phthalates. These are two of the worst offenders. BPA stands for bisphenol A. It's a chemical used to make some plastics. It is found in the lining of canned foods. It's found in receipt paper, like when you're at the grocery store and you get a receipt of purchase. Phthalates are chemicals that make plastics soft and flexible, and they are found in beauty products. So to limit these two endocrine-disrupting chemicals, especially during pregnancy, you want to choose fresh or frozen foods over canned food. You also don't want to get the receipt whenever possible. Just say no, I don't need it. Check your cosmetics for phthalates before buying. A lot of these companies nowadays will say on their label, no phthalates. So you want to look for that. High quality, low toxin, personal care and beauty products will usually say phthalate free somewhere on the label. So that's what you want to look for when shopping for your personal care products and makeup. Tip number two, choose natural cleaning products. There are harsh chemicals found in many conventional cleaning supplies or household cleaning products that are endocrine disrupting chemicals. So you want to switch to natural alternatives with ingredients like vinegar, baking soda, and essential oils, or you can make your own. Simple homemade cleaners. So remember to always choose natural, safe cleaning products. Your baby will thank you. Now let's get into the water you drink. Tip number three is filter your water. Tap water often contains traces of pollutants like lead, pesticides, and plastic chemicals that may disrupt hormones. You want to use a high quality water filter to remove these contaminants. An under sink or whole house filtration system is ideal, but even a simple faucet mounted filter is better than nothing. Moving on now to tip number four, talk to your doctor about supplements. Some supplements like vitamin D, choline, and omega-3 fatty acids are important for the baby's development and may help reduce the effects of endocrine disruptors. So discuss safe supplement options with your healthcare provider to support a healthy pregnancy. Making a few simple swaps and being vigilant about the products you use can make a big difference in your baby's lifelong health. Reducing exposure to endocrine disruptors during such a critical window of development is one of the best gifts that you can give to your child. Let's recap on how PCOS affects and contributes to fetal programming and exactly what PCOS is and how fetal programming contributes to PCOS. PCOS is a hormonal disorder that affects how a woman's ovaries work. Several factors like fetal programming may influence development of PCOS. Fetal programming refers to how a baby's development in the womb can impact their health later in life. Exposure to excess male sex hormones, remember, those are called androgens. Exposure to these androgens during fetal development may program the fetus for PCOS. If a female fetus is exposed to high levels of androgens during critical periods of development, it may cause changes that lead to PCOS later in life. Androgens, especially testosterone, stimulate the growth of ovarian cells that produce male sex hormones. This can lead to excess androgen production, a hallmark of PCOS. Exposure to androgens may also alter the development of the hypothalamus and pituitary gland, impacting hormone regulation. Several factors can lead to excess androgen exposure during fetal development. Women with PCOS or other androgen excess disorders have a higher chance of having a fetus with androgen overexposure. Also, women with insulin resistance or diabetes during pregnancy may have higher androgen levels, which can cross the placenta to the fetus. Environmental chemicals that act like hormones, also known as endocrine disruptors, are also a possible contributor. So some chemicals may impact androgen signaling or production. And so in summary, fetal programming of PCOS is complex. There's not one single cause of PCOS. However, exposure to excess androgens during critical periods of development in the womb plays an important role. Our health doesn't just start when we're born. What happens in the womb matters too. Learning about stuff like this is empowering because then we can make choices to care for our bodies in proactive ways. Whether we have PCOS or not, by understanding how PCOS originates, we can work to develop improved treatments and prevention strategies. So I know that all this info on fetal programming as a potential cause of PCOS can seem pretty overwhelming. The key is not to stress too much. While the research shows some compelling connections, the truth is that the causes of PCOS are complex and not fully understood yet. The best thing you can do is focus on what you can control, like maintaining a healthy lifestyle and managing symptoms. And remember self-care. Cut yourself some slack and remember that knowledge is power. The more we understand about PCOS, the more better equipped we'll be to advocate for ourselves and find solutions. We got this, ladies. And one last thing, a lot of women with PCOS struggle with food cravings. So if you have some food cravings, I wanna let you know that I have a free online class where I teach you how to get rid of unhealthy food cravings for good without having to give up your favorite foods. Even if you've struggled with unhealthy food cravings for many years, in the free online class, I teach you how to identify the root cause of your unhealthy food cravings and get rid of them for good. You'll also learn how to use my proven method to reduce and replace unhealthy food cravings so that you can get healthy again and lose weight quickly. So if you want to sign up for my free online class on food cravings, the link to this class is in the description box below. My name is Teresa. I'm a registered dietitian nutritionist. I'm also a health coach. And subscribe if you want to stay connected with me. See any videos I post on nutrition to learn how you can achieve your health and wellness goals for muscle gain and weight loss. And if you are a woman dealing with fertility issues, I also specialize in PCOS, endometriosis, and skin issues like acne. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video.